This is on your complete
farm. 1, 2, 3, 4. He only makes one move in here. Certainly he's got time to spare. You come and say, I think we scratch his back. He does the same. Run to Iowa and fight. Get him out too soon. That's what I like. Throw where I can't think. I get the grass. Books go books and out from scratch. 1, 2, 3, 4. Where the hell is Chris McLumber?
I should answer, where do you come from?
From the east, and I am hoping that you will give my message on the square for the sake of the widow's son.
Well done, gentlemen. Congratulations. As chairman of the Order of Skulls, and on behalf of the Council, and the 322 alumni throughout the world, gentlemen, you are welcome. Welcome home.
Gather ye rosebuds while ye may. The Latin term for that sentiment is carpe diem.
I'm loaded. I'm ready. Are you ready?
Let's go.
Let's do this.
And we are live, and the doors of the Sanctum have been unlocked and open again for this week. Welcome, everyone, back to the Sanctum. I am your illustrious host, Widow Son. My two awesome co-hosts, Jello Shots and Hooves on the Board, are backstage. And tonight, folks, yes, we are back. It's always good to be here. Hope everyone has had a good week this week, and I hope everyone is ready to learn and be horrified and all the other weird emotions that you feel around here when you come and watch us every week. So, but yes, tonight, folks, now, we understand that this is a subject tonight that has been covered a lot. So we're going to show some highlights of the Rev versus the land whale, as it were, because it was, quite the show indeed. Because I sat and actually listened to it at work the other night, and holy shit, But yeah, we're gonna check a little bit of that out. We've also got some food. As always, Cobes is gonna make a new mead, apparently. Yeah, we've got some music and all kinds of weird shit. So everyone get ready for it. But yeah, it's good to be back as always. Finally made it to my weekend off. It's been a long week at work this week, but as I've always said, this is the highlight of my week. I enjoy coming and hanging out with everybody. And tonight we are going to have some fun. God damn it, Charlie. But if you haven't already, go ahead and like the stream. That really helps us out. Hit that subscribe button. Come and get the notification bell on. And come and join our weird shenanigans every week, because we have a lot of fun around here. Going to hop over to the chat real quick and say what's up to the friends, the folks, and the bruhs. Well, there's Charlie. And the lady herself, Miss Graveyard Flowers. As always, folks, if you do not subscribe to this lady, please go and do it right now, because she's doing the Lord's work, and the Lord is good. Let's see, Brother Rickzilla, good to see you here, bruh, as always. And let's see, Lady Starfire, good to see you. Jay Gamer, good to see you as well, bruh. And everybody's kind of getting in here kind of slowly tonight, but nonetheless, we are still going to have a good time. So first and foremost,
Oh, hi,
bro. How are you?
I'm hi. How are you?
I'm stoned as fucking shit, man. How you been, bro?
Hi. How are you?
Besides hi, how have you been?
Oh, not pretty much, just hi.
So back on the Baldur's Gate once again, I've been seeing and hearing lately.
Yeah, you know, you do, you beat it on honor mode, you get that golden dice. I really want that golden dice.
I think you have found an addiction, a very serious addiction. Have you considered getting help?
No.
What up, Mo? Good to see you, bruh. And Lucifer, good to see you as well. So hey, how many times does this make that you have played and beat this game?
I've got 4 complete playthroughs so far. I'm almost done with my 5th.
Everyone, let's pray for Jello and his crippling Baldur's Gate 3 addiction.
There isn't really much other around that looks good to me at the moment. So I'm happy I'm still enjoying this one.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely.
Before we start, I would like to apologize in advance to the audience. Charlie is here to ruin the show for everyone. So,
Charlie noise.
So that's unfortunate, but
the show must go on.
Yeah, exactly. Even though he's here.
All right, well, next up.
What is it, soldier?
Well, I mean, it's pretty hairy in there. It's Charlie's point.
Charlie, don't surf!
Charlie, don't surf!
Uh-huh. Moving on.
Well, I mean, at least he understands now that he's a block of cheese.
Yeah, that's how I about feel.
But what kind? We never discussed like what kind of cheese exactly is the thing.
Well, something smelly, I would imagine.
Like Limburger, maybe.
No, you know what? It had, smelly cheese has too much character. Something really bland and.
What up, Taserface?
Sort of like unsalted cheese curds.
You know? Farmhouse cheddar.
No, you don't get to be something good like that.
Farmhouse cheddar is like the...
It's pretty plain.
Yeah, it's a bland fucking cheddar, dude. Do you even know cheese? I'm lactose intolerant, and I fucking eat the hell out of cheese. But yeah,
wonder...
The farmhouse cheddar is like the blandest cheddar you can get.
Let me tell you something, Mean Gene. Good to see you.
It's actually comparable to like... Dollar Tree slice singles.
That's what I say to that. How you been, Charlie?
Sick all week.
The hell's wrong with you now?
Wow, that's a very complicated question. You're going to have to narrow it down.
Besides the
hiv. What sickness ails you?
Well, I'm down with it.
Oh, God.
Get up, come on, get down with the sickness.
Literally talking. Yeah, that was my favorite version. That was like one of the best songs I ever heard, and it was from the Dawn of the Dead remake.
Richard Cheese.
Yes, that was a fantastic.
I've seen him live twice. He's one hell of a performer.
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, and real quick, would like to show everyone the new clip that we have that we were just graced with by Miss Mangu, who knows she's listening tonight. And thank you once again so much. Well, I'll let it speak for itself.
Oh, yeah. It's called Food Porn Individual.
I'm sorry. I could not help myself. That is like, honestly, I don't know why I find that so funny, but I do.
It's not and graveyard. It's foot, hoof, in mouth disease. Come on now.
Yeah, I mean, you may. Yeah, you do that on a pretty much regular basis.
I know. I'm surprised we're not canceled.
And on that note, folks, let the festivities begin. So you two have everything, but remember...
You must choose. But choose wisely.
What's the one that makes cows tremble?
What the fuck are you talking about now?
Isn't there another disease that cows get famously that's not...
Mad cow disease.
Mad cow disease. There you go. Yeah. That's probably what you have.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Do you want me to go ahead and play Wild Turkey Nights? Are we going to keep going with this shit?
I'm just trying to be helpful, man.
Well, real quick, I would like to bring something up for us. You guys have heard that their Instagram is gone. Like, it's been completely scrubbed, right?
As Graveyard, I believe it was Graveyard Flower says, like a phoenix from the ashes, they will rise again.
Well, of course, and then that, right, and then I put up the moving picture of Free Willy or Willy jumping over the wall. So I mean,
am I the only one that really wanted the whale not to make that jump and crush the kid?
Good God, man!
Sorry.
Yeah. No. All right, Jello. What is this?
Well, you know how I always say about learning. That's yes. Right. It's both fun and fundamental. So of here's course. A singer that likes to...
We're pretty mental.
Head over to his drummer during, the shows and just kind of tell him some random facts.
Okay.
Like this one that he's telling him right here is most American cars' car horns are in the key of F.
Hello, Sydney. Wow. Wow. That's got to be the most awkward moment of the night, every night. Like, awkward moment.
What band is this?
I have no clue.
Random facts from your front man. But what up, Mr. H?
It's just the singer walking over to the drummer. It's not for anyone besides the drummer. It's just their little thing. A skunk can be smelled from over a mile away.
That is awesomely amazing.
I want this guy as my friend. The founder of Atari is also the creator of Chuck E. Cheese.
Wow.
Elephant's the only mammal with four knees.
What the fuck? He looks so confused.
Oh, that was fun.
I wow. Like, I don't know what to say to that, to be honest with you. Like, fucking, wow.
Hang on. We have more fun facts if you'd like.
Sure, go ahead.
Okay. Right now, folks, we're trying to soften the blow before we watch clips of the battle at sea. Was born.
True facts about Morgan Freeman.
Born in 1937, he narrated his own birth, saying, "Leaving the warm comfort of his mother's womb, I, Morgan Freeman, enter the world. Soon I will make my first poop, one of many in the life of Morgan Freeman. The first time that Morgan Freeman saw himself crying in the mirror, he became old, and he remained that way his whole life. From then on, every time that Morgan Freeman cried, it rained. In heaven. When Morgan Freeman makes a documentary film, he narrates it first, and then nature makes it so. The only reason that the sun rises each day is because Morgan..."
What?
Wow.
This is almost like Chuck Norris.
Yeah, pretty close, right?
It's amazing. I brought some Chuck Norris facts.
Hell yeah.
Awesome.
What the fuck did I walk in on? Well, hello, Fenton Covey.
I also have, I actually have more violent true facts after you do the Chuck Norris thing. It kind of all ties together.
"At sunrise, in his dreams the night before, the only reason that you're alive right now is because Morgan Freeman is narrating your life, as he does for billions and billions of others each day. And when you have a bout of diarrhea, Morgan Freeman narrates it so that you appear noble, at the mercy of nature, and a taco. Morgan Freeman goes through 4 or 5 microphones a day because his voice turns them into bars of gold, which he uses to fund his quest to create a real Santa Claus. Morgan Freeman cannot be cloned because that would require unicorn tears. Morgan Freeman doesn't have sex.
What up, Drew?
When he smiles, a baby simply appears in a field full of kittens. Earthquakes are merely Mother Nature having an orgasm when she listens to March of the Penguins. Penguins didn't exist until Morgan Freeman made that movie. He's that good. If you're having a rough day, think about Morgan Freeman, because he's certainly thinking about you. Morgan."
Wow.
I love Morgan Freeman.
Holy shit. Morgan Freeman. Like, just... I honestly almost want to watch that video and just count how many times he says Morgan Freeman.
I thought you would appreciate
that. Holy shit. Fuck yeah, man. Jello, let's hear some music. I want to hear some music. We've got some good stuff tonight from I think you got some and I sent you quite a bit.
I got rid of that one because it's all video, remember?
Oh, no, I was talking about some the others I sent you.
You said you got some, like I had bought some, but those stuff I had brought.
Oh, oh, yeah. All right, but let's hear some music, folks, shall we? God, you and Billy just jumping around dressed as elves is just weird, man. Like, it just gets weirder and weirder the more I see it.
I enjoy it.
Of course you do. Because you're Charlie and you enjoy weird things.
No, because it makes Billy look like a jackass. Because, you know, I do have my thoughts on that.
Ah, yes. Now, one of my favorite old performers is Cab Calloway. And being the stoner that I am, I found a song that he did called Reefer Man. And this was a little short that I came across of it. And I thought that we could all watch it tonight for those smoking and toking in the audience this evening. So let's listen to some Cab Calloway.
"Have you ever met that funny reefer man? Have you ever met that funny reefer man? If he says he swam to China, wants to sell you South Carolina. then you know you're talking to that reefer man.
Reefer man!
Have you ever met that funny reefer man?
Reefer man!
Oh, that funny, funny, funny reefer man.
Reefer man!
He betrayed you dimes for nickels. He says watermelons are pickles. You know you're talking to that reefer man.
Reefer man!
Oh, have you ever met that funny reefer man?
Reefer man!
Oh, that funny, funny, funny reefer man.
It's such a good song.
He smokes a reefer, he gets high, then he flies to the sky. That funny, funny, funny reefer man. Have you ever met that funny reefer man?
I thought that that would just be something. Just something a little fun for us to see this evening.
I appreciate you trying to bring the mood up, but we are supposed to be covering a fight tonight.
Well, yes, we are, but we're trying to soften the blow.
I think we ought to amp the people up. And so I have found a particular set of videos, and I'll share with them one of you. Everybody know? Everybody loves Perry Caravello, right?
Right.
Yeah.
Okay, because he rages the fuck out, right?
You can put this one down and put up whatever he's going to put up.
So imagine Perry in a red hat and blue overalls. And I present to you Pissed Off Mario.
Mario, I have captured the prince.
Now hold on a second. You, what the fuck is your problem? You stupid cunt!
Wow, you're really mad.
What number is this? Do you get off on being captured? You stupid bitch!
Easy there, buddy.
Do you think I don't have a life? Do you think I don't have shit to do? I'm a goddamn plumber!
Do you need me to step outside?
I've killed so many motherfucking turtles! If I see another one of those goddamn things!
They're just doing their job.
Jesus Christ, man.
Don't even get me started on you fat fuck!
You think I'm fat?
This is the last time! The last goddamn time I'm saving your stupid ass! We're gonna go home and guess what you're sucking? My balls!
Whoa!
When are we gonna do our fight?
If you wanna fight somebody, go find my fucking retard brother! I'm sick of this shit!
I don't think Luigi's that bad.
Yeah, I always kind of liked Luigi a little bit more. Like, he was just overshadowed by Mario. So I was always more of a Luigi fan. Good Lord, man. That, wow, Hooves. That's different. Well, speaking of fights, let's see some clips of this epic battle of man versus beast.
Wait, hold on. Before we watch a couple of failures, I brought a short of people being awesome. I thought it might be fun to just watch people be, it'll feel good for a minute, and then we'll watch idiots be terrible people. How's that sound?
Sounds good.
Whoa. Je suis pas celle que tu crois, aucun cabron ne m'a touché. À part toi, caballero, personne ne m'a touché.
Okay, that's pretty badass.
Cocaïne,
whoa. I'm not impressed with your first videos too much. Unless they're really well done. Okay, that's pretty fucking slick.
Yeah, that was slick. For real.
Sorry, I was queuing up the other video. I didn't see the guy on a bike. That was actually pretty damn slick.
Hell yeah, it was.
I've also got another short like that of cute dogs. We can watch that after Rev and Shanny so that we don't have to,
grow them.
We don't have to have that taste in our mouth.
Ugh. Okay. So
I don't think Rev wants that taste in his mouth.
No, I don't think he does.
No, he does, obviously.
He's spending a lot of time emailing other flavors. I'm just saying.
Yeah, that That's some fucked up, repugnant shit, man. Because
it's
like,
really not, though.
Well, I
could you imagine being stuck with her?
Well, I mean, no. What I mean by that is like the fact that it had to turn into this whole big motherfucking blowout, and like, but it was great to see. I mean, motherfucker, we hadn't got a fight like that since he spit on her.
Have we all watched the fight? Everybody in chat? Did anybody in chat not watch the fight? Because
put a one,
you know,
in the chat.
I would like to be able to discuss it without having to worry about spoilers. But everybody's been overplaying it. I felt like I just didn't want to watch the whole video here because.
Oh no! With that,
I figured why do that to everybody else?
We got timestamps. They're only about 6 or 7 minutes long each one.
Oh, the spit was great. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
The spit was probably the best.
The
Taser
spit
face
was priceless.
It.
What does that mean? The whole thing, though, like when he did T-Rex arms at her, you know? On my own video when he screamed. Oh.
If one of our mods can put the link to Graveyard Flowers video here in the chat, I'd appreciate it.
We have
Graveyard has a wrench.
Put a link to her channel, actually. Once again, folks, if you don't already subscribe to Graveyard Flowers, go and do it right now.
Taser, you might be able to like listen to the whole thing in its entirety. You know, maybe tomorrow when you're off doing something or you're driving or something and you want something to listen to that makes you feel like a better human.
It's like an hour and a half. But
oh,
it's
sorry.
It's like watching a Jerry Springer show. You look at yourself and you go, you know what? I'm not such a piece of shit after all. So,
all right,
watching them gaslight each other and just be terrible people at each other.
Oops,
it's fun.
No, we're not watching that one again. My bad. Go back here.
And you said
there is
I'm
some fake crying.
Yes, lots of fake crying. Whale cries galore, folks. There's some neck things. There's a lot of shouting. I mean, it's interesting. So,
all right, here we go.
Let's do this.
Oh, quiet for the anthem. Why are we buffering? God, I love that.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Oh, one more time.
Like the stream, folks.
Absolutely. Absolutely. 100 billion fucking thousand trillion goddamn fucking percent.
Well,
done
fuck, Rev.
With the invasion of my privacy and harassment of people to watch for my new email address that I have that I really wish there was a way to block, and there probably is, but they always change the fucking settings on Google and you don't know where to go.
No, they don't. It's very easy to block an email
address. I can totally shut off on my Google profile. I lost track of what I was thinking.
He wants other people to not be able to see his email address.
Oh,
on his profile.
Displaying the email. That's it. This is a tactic of these people that harass you and want to make you fucking kill yourself. Because that's what's happening.
See, that's bullshit, though. Hold on, pause that a second.
They're using me to get to Shannon.
Sorry, my mouse took a second to queue up. Go ahead.
What's bullshit? Like he starts this by saying he wishes people couldn't get his email address. All right. The problem is that this girl sent, body shots, whatever, titty pics, I think, to him, and Shanny saw them, and now he's in trouble. And look, it's one thing if she just hunted down his email address and that were the case, which is what he's trying to make it sound like. The fact is, and you'll hear them, and he admits it, that he told her to send them there so Shanny wouldn't see them. You know, like he's a... I know, look at Rev and go, what an idiot. He's... he's dumb, but he will do these. Like, he knows when he's doing wrong, and he tries to lie to cover it up.
The retcons from this were unreal. from what I've seen of them. But the fact that he's still, they still try to take all of this as harassment. This is not harassment. People aren't actually, like, honestly, you're still the kind of motherfuckers that if you were actually getting these things, which we all know that the pictures and everything was actually happening, but a lot of the stuff they've talked about in the past, like, you're the kind of motherfuckers that would throw that up so everybody could see it, but you don't. So you don't provide, I mean, excuse me, I know I'm spitting logic here, and that scares the two of you, because you're both dumb as fucking shit, but, I mean, fuck.
But here's the deal. All right, Shanny, okay, first of all, in this instance, this particular instance, Rev is a dickwad. They are both dickwads, because Shanny has done this to Rev with Liquid Drag, several other people and trolls. At one point, she had a girlfriend while quote-unquote married, because they're not really fucking married. Pennsylvania does not recognize common law. That went out in 2018, I believe. It might have been 2016. No, they're both pieces of shit. This is actually the first time Rev's actually standing up for himself. So I wouldn't say I'm behind him, but I kind of gave an attaboy when he's giving a shit to her, because she spent the last how many years now manipulating him all the way to the poorhouse, and he's just up from having downs. I mean, seriously, she gave him the wet brain. She did this to him.
Oh yeah, definitely. All right, let's go.
They're both pieces of shit.
Total. My bad. I didn't mean to interrupt you, brother.
And it's been pretty crazy. Okay. But I know your tactics. I know why you do this. The goal here is for you to have a badge on your fucking dark web profile that you have a legitimate suicide video. Well, I'm telling.
What the fuck are you talking about, man? Jesus Christ.
See, this is the fun part. He is spitting shit to cover himself, at the same time has the brain power of, you know, a potato. Hamster. Potato, sure. Potato with hair. So he's stupid. And right now he's trying to cover his ass the best he can. And he's going to turn around and, you know, do some more fun stuff. Moving on.
I'm telling you that that's not going to happen, because I won't let it happen. I know that you absolute disgusting sacks of shit have taken my email and put it in dating sites.
Thank God. He sounds
to so make good. Me look like I am trying to cheat on her. You've even gone as far as to...
You have no proof of that. None whatsoever. Like, if you were actually getting that shit, the videos we would have gotten about that would have been glorious. I mean, we would have probably got another scarlet letter at that point. I'm like, who are you trying to kid, Rev?
Yeah, nobody thinks that anybody's going to go on a walking date with you, Rev. It's just weird, man.
Oh God, let's go.
Write a fake fucking. It's like if you went into a fucking stall at Waffle House and put Betty's a good time. Call 5355-2121. You did the same fucking thing to me. On
this
an internet dating profile, which
smoke screen. This is all smoke screen and obfuscation. That's like,
was he saying that Shanny's mom was a good time?
I didn't even think about that. Holy fuck, Rev.
But he's throwing shade right out there, too.
I'm never sure her name was Betty.
Yeah, that's what I said. And he said, that's like going to Waffle House and putting for a good time, call Betty.
Oh, okay.
You want me to rewind that so you hear it again?
No, I'll take your word for it.
Right on. Thank you.
Touched one of those sites in my fucking life. But this is harassment. This is how you do this.
However, he does have a subscription at the Real Love Doll website.
And I am absolutely done with it. every way that I can get off the internet without having something to do with it for work related issues. That is work. The only place.
Oh yeah. Run it back. We gotta see the whole neck thing.
Yeah, I'm just trying to. Where we at?
There we go.
239.
Right. Yeah.
Here we go.
Waffle House and put Betty's a good time. Call 535-552-121. You did the same fucking thing to me on an internet dating profile, which I've never touched one of those sites in my fucking life. But this is harassment. This is how you do this. And I am absolutely done with it.
Airplane coming.
Every way that I can get off the internet without having something to do with it for work-related issues, that is the only place. And listen
to this.
There it is. Whoa! Holy shit. Man, how does he not snap his own neck at some point?
Like, why not? Why doesn't he?
No, I've never actually watched this. I've only listened because, you know, I work. So, like, I knew about the one neck thing. I don't know if there's more in this.
Oh, there's more. There's more.
Neck thing typically means he's lying.
Oh, no.
The thing that he does at the beginning of this that really annoys me when anybody does it, when he's... with this insane number, this insane percentage of how done he is with it, right?
A 100 million percent.
Yeah, you know, there's no more than 100%, right? Like that's all of it. Like, you know,
right.
Saying 1,000 or 10,000% or whatever, it doesn't. It just makes me angry when I hear people doing that. I don't know why. I guess it's a pet peeve.
Could be. All right, let's speed him up just a hair, and
he
then
is. He's on 1.25.
You're kidding.
No.
Okay.
Look, hold on. Shit. I'll prove this because you guys can see my settings pop up. 1.25.
Wow. Let's go just a little bit more.
All right, we're just going chipmunk. All right, let's do it.
Well, it's not chipmunk.
There, I did the neck thing for you because I'm starting to get indigestion because of the fucking dog shit that you've caused in my fucking life. You have bullied me so bad and stolen my fucking identity by taking my email and putting it in dating things that are
No one's stolen his ID. No one's bullying him.
If someone stole your ID, your credit score would go up.
How weak of a person are you that you can say that someone's bullying you online as an adult? The fuck's wrong with this dude? Like,
what up, Skits?
Yeah, he's making me sleepy. You look
like who, him or me?
Rev.
Okay.
Let's go ahead and go to the next timestamp. Let's let this pick up. Right. Just a little bit for everybody. The yelling and the whale cries galore.
But whatever I'm guilty of, let's confront. You want to say it, and I'll admit everything.
That- now hold on. Now this is important. This is when she comes in later in the video. She says something that totally contradicts it. If it's not in the time stance, I'll cover it. But this is important. Just the interaction.
That is true.
You're telling her to send pics to your private email. There. I got to go to the bathroom. Can you excuse me?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, how about that one?
Yeah, I say if you send pics like that, send it to my email. Yeah,
that's wrong.
Yeah, I own it. I said, Shanny does not like seeing you this way. So if you must send pictures like that, send it here, not there. And that was to protect Shanny from being triggered by her impulsive sending of nudes, because that's what she was doing. Now, hey, Rev, why didn't you just say, don't ever send any pictures? Because I already said that in Instagram, and then she proceeded to send pictures of her pussy.
Yeah, but then you say send four pics.
No, I did! Shit.
Okay, did you hear that? The cat piped in.
At this point, like she's going to have no friends if she keeps attacking me. She's going to have no friends at all. I'm still on her side, but she's not on my side. See, you guys got what you wanted. You wanted division, and you made it.
Shanny has friends.
It's everybody else's fault. You're asking a girl for nudes, and everybody else is to blame.
No,
this is like Cyrax. This is just like Cyrax.
This is he actually went about this a little smarter because he didn't actually ask for them. He worded shit right to keep himself out of trouble. I think
he did ask for him in that he said, send him here.
I love tattoos. If you have more, send them here. Because he never actually said.
That's asking for more.
But he didn't actually say send nudes. He's covering his ass. What I'm pointing out here is he's slowly becoming more self-aware. Because he was covering himself.
He's trying to cover himself the best he can, yeah.
That's what I'm saying. So he's slowly getting, oh my God, he's learning.
And his lies are so transparent. Like it's... He's so stupid. He actually thinks that other people are as stupid as him. Like, he's as smart as he can muster. You know what I mean?
Right. Well, bear in mind, the human brain, after you kill off brain cells, you can actually teach other parts of your brain to do the parts that are now dead. It's been known to happen. It's how people learn to walk again. Part of their brain gets damaged or whatever, and then they learn how to talk again because they're using a whole nother part of their brain. It is possible for him to actually be getting smarter, which I actually would love that because I want to see that explosion. But I digress. It's a pipe dream and a fantasy. Moving on.
Oh, yeah.
So fun with that because she feels like she's my enemy now. But if she ends up killing herself, it's all on you. You guys did this, and you know it. You messed with an emotionally unstable woman.
Everyone else
many
is to
times.
Blame.
Hold
mad
on,
at Rev, for what Rev did, but it's everybody else's fault.
Put a one in the chat if you remember helping him put his hand on his dick while he was getting the tit pics. I didn't think so. Moving on.
Put a two in chat if you like putting twos in chat.
Put twos in chat if you like putting twos in chat. Yes.
Just block her and listen to Shanny for what? Yeah, I'm blocking her. She is blocked. The reason that I was, this is the bottom line, and I don't want to hurt her, but she loves hurting me and hurting my family, so I'm ready to fucking hurt Ashley. The only reason I talked to this woman was for money.
Motherfucking
she handed us $50 in a day, and I said, whoa, holy shit, I really need money. So I'm going to remember this, and I'm going to talk.
Well, Graveyard Flowers just answered the question of all questions.
To you, because I need money.
But what is the question?
That's the only reason I ever talked to her.
You didn't
because
ask that.
I am very happy and fulfilled in my marriage and sex life.
You're not.
I'm sorry. I got a little lightheaded right there. Sorry. I thought I was going to Ralph. Ouch. Okay. I think we're at this. I think we're at that one that we can stop now. Are we? Did we get there? No, God damn it. We still have 3 minutes. Motherfucker.
Last night, we had the best sex we ever had. And then you guys came in with your disgusting fucking agents to try and manipulate our relationship yet again.
This didn't happen overnight, homeboy. This happened last week and the week before.
It didn't happen at all, right? Like, I mean, the thing that... I guess there was a little bit of manipulation. Like, someone was willing to send him some nude pics in order to, like, you know, spill the beans to everyone. So I guess there was some manipulation there, but like, he's still guilty of everything he did. Right. Like, you know, it's like, when I compared him to Cyrax, it's like when they decoy Cyrax and he wants to call, Masshole a pedo, because they pretended to be younger than they were to lure him.
Yeah.
But he was still drawn in by what he believed was a young person, whether they're a decoy or not. That's not someone else's fault. That's on you, buddy. So Rev is like doing the same kind of thing here, you know? Just a blame or... Hey, Matt, haven't yet played any Perry, but we will.
All right, moving on.
No, let's look at this for a minute. Okay, it's fine.
That's not true.
Yeah, it is.
Called email. That's why I'm upset.
Yeah, you guys won.
No.
Yeah.
You shouldn't have sent her that email.
They won. You got what you wanted. You sent this girl to do these things, and she did them.
And
there you go. Yeah, there you go. See, even she's for you too. Isn't that awesome? You want to kill her and have her commit suicide, and she's for you.
Who are you talking about?
You. You guys won. You won.
Can you light the fucking cigarette already?
But if she asked me to go get her a fucking soda.
I mean, their relationship is so codependent. Like, she's got him believing that he can't live without her, when really it's the other way around. Like, they've both admitted that he wipes her butt for her. You know,
he wipes a booty hole.
So, like, let's say Shanny was able to pack clothes and carry a suitcase and leave that house that belongs to Rev's uncle, right?
Right.
Let's say she could get into a woman's shelter. Let's say she could fit in the door. Who at the woman's shelter is going to wipe her ass?
Don't worry, Drew. They went away.
Like, is she just going to have a messy behind?
No, she can get a rag on a stick.
She have to, like, we'll go with the rag and the stick. I don't want to think about that anymore. Oh, God. All right, let's keep going.
Still, I will. If she asks me for help in the bathroom, I will help her with 100% because I love her. It's a testimony to love. That's what it is.
No, it's there a testimony that you're a
anything
sucker.
Anything that she would need at this second, if she were to be having health problems, I would immediately drop whatever the fuck I'm doing.
I still don't get why you gave her your email just to say, send me your pics.
Well, Gavin got some shit to
say. I was literally saying, if you're going to send shit like
Jason,
that.
You should have said, don't send any pics.
I did.
Yeah.
In Instagram.
And then you gave her a mixed message and said, send them here so Shanny doesn't see them.
If you impulsively send shit, send
Jason,
it there.
How do you think if it was you, what would you think?
I don't know. I don't know, Shannon.
Yeah, well, maybe you should think about that. Go in my shoes and see how I would feel.
Fine.
And think how you would feel if you were in that scenario.
Go to my shoes.
Using your AIG again.
You should go to my shoes and see how I feel.
Those shoes have got to look like clown shoes by now because you know she blew out the suspension.
Ugh, shut up.
I was doing.
No, I don't. Like, no.
That's what I was doing.
You wouldn't have said, I like tattoos. I love them. Big old L-O-V-E.
That was literally just like saying, yeah, I love tattoos.
You don't think that leads her on?
No.
I already seen
her body.
Yeah, good for you. You've seen her body.
And you did too. You did too. Yeah. Make me your enemy.
I'm not making you my
enemy. You already did.
I see what I see.
Good. So you guys got, and you give them content. You are giving them content.
I'm not.
You, yeah, you are.
You're the one who turned on the camera and said you needed to make a video.
Yeah. And I was standing up for you again like an idiot.
Yeah. Well, don't stand up for me. Say that I'm a horrible person for me being upset that you'd say that and being upset with other things. Go ahead. Tell me how much of an awful person I am.
You've been extremely emotionally abusive to me over the years. Yeah.
I have not been.
Yes, you have.
Oh,
you absolutely have.
Because
yeah.
I'm mad because I see you wanting another woman?
No, which never happened. Never.
Yeah.
Well, never happened.
You know what? When you tell someone you want to see their pics, guess what that means?
I didn't say that.
Yeah, okay.
I didn't say it.
Send your pics here.
Instead of IG to protect Shannon.
No, that's not what you said.
That's exactly what I said.
Heart.
Like, does everybody remember when he got caught sending dick pics to, like, Bob?
Oh,
His claim then was that he was trolling. I'm going to troll you by sending you my dick pic. How does that make any fucking sense? But that's really how stupid he is.
Finished with this. I'm fine with it.
Yeah, I know.
I mean, I could try to use that as an excuse, but HR still doesn't believe it.
You are because you want to finish your single joint.
Oh. Neither does
your
sister. You're
helping me, and you put that on me too. You...
I'm sorry. Do I look like I'm from Mississippi?
You see that, folks?
I didn't put that on you. I know. I'm horrible.
Yeah.
Yes. I know I'm going through a lot, and I need help. Yes. But I need help.
Yep.
And I'm horrible for needing help.
No, you twisted it to your own. You are a total narcissist.
How?
A complete narcissist.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
No, I'm not.
Yep.
No, I'm not.
Denial, Shanny.
No, because I ask questions. Because I get upset because I see my man go to another woman.
You
It's never happened.
Well, that's how I see it.
Never happened. It never
Jason,
happened.
You said you wanted to move to Norway. You saw her pics. You said send your pics here. I don't know what you said to her other than that. You could be erasing messages and stuff.
Oh, God.
I didn't erase any messages. You erased every message that was ever erased. You did. Because you're so insecure, you can't even see another woman's body. That's how insecure you are. When I don't look at anybody but you.
That's why you asked for her pics, right?
Yeah, go to hell, Shannon. Oh, yeah, you're already there.
Oh!
Gaslight me to hell, fine.
I'm not gaslighting you. I'm just saying what you're saying. I don't understand why.
I'm done.
You can't even answer me that question.
You want answers, answers, answers. You want me to talk forever. You hate my voice, too.
I love how Shanny cannot let it go. Like, they keep doing circles after circles.
I don't do that. I say quiet now, please.
Yeah, it's unbelievable. Like, my life has been just fucking destroyed.
Why do you have to do this to me?
You ripped my soul out, dude.
You're so mean to me.
You ripped my soul out.
You're so mean to me. I didn't do anything to you other than ask a question.
Yeah. Right.
Why do I have to be the bad guy? Because I didn't do anything.
Yeah,
Chris says I'm the bad guy and I didn't do anything. I was just working my ass off.
She wasn't working her ass off.
And yeah, I was really wasn't... sick and it doesn't matter. They'll still hurt me.
She wasn't working when she was me. With Chris, was she?
They don't care. They don't care. I'll take it.
See how now she's saying they'll always hurt me? She's not even talking to Rev anymore. She's just playing to the camera. She's playing to the audience. She's... it doesn't matter. They'll just hurt me. Talking about all the men in her life, like she's gonna have any others.
I don't think she's going to have any others at all. Actually,
I kind of doubt it.
Oh yeah, I seriously doubt it.
We need that dig, Doug. Those diglets video from Frank.
Yeah, well, right, Lucifer, but what I mean is her ass got bigger and bigger.
I know how much Jello enjoys the sound.
And I kind of disagree, Lucifer. I think she can. I think she doesn't want to.
Okay, let's go to the next one.
She got a little quiet. I was waiting to see if it got built up. Because like I said, I was looking for one in particular, which I don't think we got.
Oh, no. There's definitely a few spots where she cries good.
Well, I'm talking about what you that one.
Cowardly lion style.
Yeah, I never even look at emails. I never look at that email address ever. I never look at it ever. Never.
What did they say the name of that email address was?
Eager Beaver Pleaser. I'm actually fist on a chest. Yeah, good one, dude.
Let me tell you a little secret. Guys will already know this, but maybe some of the ladies in the audience may not. Any guy that has an email account that's named anything like Eager Beaver Pleaser
usually
definitely
sucks
checks that account. They definitely does. That's not an account that they don't look at often.
My one email is I don't know why my underwear has skid marks, so I don't check that one.
Lord. All right, let's keep going.
You put intentions on me. You put words in me.
I'm not putting words in you. You said exactly what you said.
You put words in my mouth.
What words did I put in your mouth?
Heart. Bullshit.
You said
a lot of hearts.
Money. And you love that money, too, because it gets your soda.
Her soda.
Yes, the very truth, and you know it. I give a fuck.
Yeah, keep trying to turn it around on me, I see.
like turn it around on you.
I'm so sick of my heart being broken.
You do it to yourself.
I didn't do shit.
Yeah. There's no intention here. I'm telling you, there was no intention. None. No sexual intention at all. None.
Except to get some titty pics where you could hide them from Shanny.
Zero.
If you want to send titty pics, please send them to my to my Twitter account. I will inspect every one of them and rate them at a number 1 through 10.
And that link.
More than likely, they'll all be 8, 9, and 10s because I like all boobies.
That was on your links. Mm-hmm.
There's no way in hell anybody's going to believe this whole no sexual intent, considering the fact that, as Shanny brought up and he admitted, he was trying to get Shanny interested in moving there.
Oh, God.
The fun thing about lies is you have to remember those lies, and dude, you got Dane Bramage, so it's not happening.
That brain is as slick as an ice rink, folks.
Ah, damn. Smooth, no lumps.
All right, let's go.
Unlike Shanny's body.
Ugh. How do you think I should feel? If it was you, how would you feel about it?
I would look at the reality of the situation, that we are trolled by quite a few people. And they take our emails and our, even our personal addresses.
Yeah, but here's the thing. You still talk to her, regardless if you know she's a troll or
not.
That's
a separate fucking issue. You're talking about dishonesty, a girl. You were there from the fucking beginning.
I didn't say anything to her. I didn't even know what you
were
talking to her about.
Yes, because you don't even care who gives us money anymore.
Why would I want to talk to anyone over everything?
Neither one of you. All right, wait a minute. Wait a minute.
Yeah.
Wait, okay, neither one of you care who gives you money because... You found people that are still stupid enough to actually give you money. You don't care about these fucking people. You just want them to feel sorry for you.
Right, but his point is that he responds to these people to thank them for sending money. Shanny won't even do that. She just lets people know she needs money and then fuck you.
He doesn't give a flying fuck. I mean, he makes a valid point.
Yeah, but fuck that, though. We don't give him a pass. Everything is about deflecting from what he did.
Oh, absolutely. Everything but I like that he's telling on. Don't get me wrong. I am not giving him any kind of kudos whatsoever.
What I'm saying is
it's awesome because they're telling on each other.
There's actually a point where he starts yelling at her for introducing him to people on G+.
Rhett Campbell or something like that?
Rand Campbell.
That's
Do you know about him?
I do not, thankfully. He
was the best. He was this, Christian dude who, he was like a bad guy wrestler. He was just like really good at making everybody angry at him. And I started practicing doing his voice. And then I spent like 3 months watching his videos for at least an hour every day, practicing doing him. And I actually got better at being Rand Campbell than you were at being Mud.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
And then I'd follow him around into like religious debate rooms and argue with him as himself.
And I don't know. Charlie's Mud impression is pretty good.
I don't sound like that.
Ask Drag. Drag was around for it. You ask him how good I was.
All right, let's go.
I don't want
to thank people. I thank people. I keep track of who fucking gives money to us, and I go to say thank you. That's what I was doing with her.
Good cover.
That's it. Because somebody said this.
But yeah, you guys are talking about you moving to Norway together.
No, she suggested that me and you go for a visit. That's it. Nothing else was discussed. You're making stuff up.
I'm not making anything.
Yes, you are.
What am I making up?
That we were going to move there.
You've been talking about moving there.
Get the fuck out of this country. Anywhere. I don't care.
Then you say I'm making it up. You admit that I said that.
I've been talking about getting out of this country anywhere. It's not Norway anywhere.
No, you've been talking about Norway for quite a while.
Yeah, because we started talking to someone trying to.
No, you started talking.
You talk. To this woman. Now you
barely because
that.
You brought her in our lives.
See how you fucking lying sack of shit. You are such a liar.
Oh, really? Who's the one who first initiated conversation?
Because a person gives money and I go say thank you. It's bringing another woman into our relationship. You psycho.
Obviously, you're an idiot.
Good God.
I am when you're talking about moving away.
Everything's a deflection. We started talking with her. He started talking with her. He knows it.
Uh-huh. I didn't use you.
Yes,
I loved you.
You're disgusting. And you used my
I think my enjoyment comes out of the fact that he is being her. This is all the shit she has said to him.
True.
Well, he's right. Like she has been using him. She did use the fuck out of him, but it doesn't really.
It doesn't matter at this point. It's done.
Like he's only saying it because he doesn't want this about what he's done.
I mean, dude, at this point, kick her the fuck out, or just let the fact that you lost $750,000 go. One of the two.
I don't think that'll. He needs something to hold over her head.
Well, she can't hold her arms over her head. So
look how terrible she is, though. She's willing, and she is in before on the stream. She used the fact that she took care of him for a year while he was wet-brained, even though she's the one that put him there.
Oh yeah, she's the one that did it. She said that they were moving to Colorado.
Used it against him in a fight, though. It's really fucked up. So someone as low as that, you got to keep some ammunition hanging out in your pocket, you know?
Well, that's what I mean. I think he's a total piece of shit in this fight. But the only gold star I can give him is the fact that he is throwing shit out there that A, did happen, and they're telling truths on each other, and B, he's using some of the tactics that she's used on him. I mean, when you live together, you start being like each other. So, I mean, Shanny, you kind of built this monster yourself.
Can we take a quick poll of the audience? Do y'all feel tortured? Would you rather not watch any more of this? Have we heard it enough?
I feel like I'm talking to them.
Am I the only person that's watched this 3 or 4 times?
Yeah, I think there's only one person in this audience that hasn't seen it yet.
But is this somebody that gives a shit about them, though?
He's okay.
Okay, put one in chat if you feel like you're being tortured. 2 if you want to continue. So let's see what the folks have to say. I mean,
Mo just said the good part's coming up, so apparently he wants to hear some more.
Okay, we'll hear a little bit more then.
Do you want me to skip up to the next one? Because your 2 timestamps are like literally right next to each
other. Yeah. Go ahead.
These people, I don't even have a clue.
What is your fucking paranoia now toward me? It's not paranoia at all. What paranoia is it? I don't do anything other than love you.
Right.
Don't do anything other than love you.
This is exactly what you do. We love.
What did I do?
I came on here to make a statement that I love my wife more than anything.
Yeah, you sure showed it.
Yeah, and then you started attacking me on air.
Okay, did you hear that part?
I watched it a couple of times the night it happened, man. I was like, this is good. I had like messaged Hooves and everybody, a few people. I was like, we got to listen to it in the Discord. I'm like telling everybody, don't listen to it. Meet me in the Discord. We'll all listen to it together.
Okay. So now that was something super important that he just said. Let's see if I can get back a little bit.
Call me and ask you
to go. Because he wanted to talk to you.
It's really fucked up and weird. These people, I don't even have a clue.
What is your fucking paranoia now toward me?
It's not paranoia at all.
What paranoia is it? I don't do anything other than love you.
Right. This is exactly what you do. We love.
What did I do?
I came on here to make a statement that I love my wife more than anything.
Yeah, you sure showed it.
Yeah, and then you started attacking me on air.
No, I didn't attack you. I asked a question.
Go do.
Okay, did you catch that?
That she didn't attack him?
That she didn't attack him, she just asked a question. We listened to the beginning already, just about a few minutes ago. She did attack him. She went at him. There was no questions asked. Everything she threw was shade. So now she's lying to him. He actually spoke a truth there. That he was... He went on here to lie to, you know, defend his wife, whatever. And then she attacked him. And then she says, no, I asked a question. No, you fucking did attack him. So the amount of lying and gaslighting that goes on here is enormous. Don't let him match in there. I'm surprised he's smoking and didn't blow up the house.
Do reaction videos and reveal it, guys, what she did to me. I was being nothing but supportive of you, and you attacked me.
How did I attack
you? How? Go see it, guys.
How did I attack
Go
you?
Go see it.
How did I attack you?
Check it out, guys.
How did I attack you? By asking a question?
Question.
Yeah, asking a question is attacking, right?
On video. I was nothing but supportive of you. You attacked me.
No, I asked a question.
No, you attacked me.
I asked a question. And which you still have not answered.
Contrary to popular belief, guys, I am not completely cut. I'm not.
Whoa!
Everybody put X's in the doubt in the chat for doubt. X's in the chat for doubt. Fuck, I can't talk.
So when I get gaslit to this point, you're in.
I'm not gaslighting you. I asked a question.
The whole time you gaslit.
I asked a question.
From the fucking moment you started.
How did I get to you?
X's in the chat for gout. S's in the chat for gout.
I talk like Billy Reeds.
Okay, then how did I try to refer to what's going on exactly by asking a question that you that came out of your mouth?
Come on, Shanny, put an S. Type an S.
You don't see a problem with what you said.
No. Oh, yes. I worded it badly. I did.
It sounded like you were coming on to her and you were sneaking around.
That I will own because it did sound that way. I will own that.
Yeah, I guess I'm not a pig anymore because that's the only problem I had, but you couldn't answer it.
No, you're still a pig.
But I'm telling you,
but I'm so abusive.
Yes, you are. Because you gaslit me to a point where I fucking flipped
out. I didn't gaslight
you. Yes, you fucking did.
No, I didn't.
You're putting intentions on me that I did not have. That's gaslighting.
I see what you write.
And the intention was not sex. Or to see her fucking tits or pussy.
So why do you keep saying you want to go to Norway?
Because I went out of this country.
I don't know. I kind of like boobs.
Yeah, convenient that the girl that's been coming on to you and you keep talking to.
Because she's the one saying, come here.
Yeah, and you're like, yeah, let's go.
Yeah.
Like, well, yeah, go to her then.
Go, I will.
There it is.
There it is. All right, let's hear it.
Let's do that again.
You would drive the most sane person in the planet nuts.
Yeah, I guess I'm not a pig anymore because that's the only problem I had, but you couldn't answer it.
Still a pig.
But I'm telling you, you're.
But I'm so abusive.
Yes, you are, because you gaslit me to a point where I fucking flipped
out. I didn't gaslight you.
You fucking did.
No, I didn't.
You're putting intentions on me that I did not have. That's gaslighting.
I see what you write.
And the intention was not sex or to see her fucking tits or pussy.
So why do you keep saying you want to go to Norway?
Because I went out of this country.
Yeah, convenient that the girl that's been coming on to you and you keep talking to.
Because she's the one saying, come here.
Yeah, and you're like, yeah, let's go.
Yeah.
Like, go to her then.
Go ahead, I will. You would drive the most sane person in the planet nuts.
Go to her. Go to her then.
Go ahead, I will.
Go to her then.
Go ahead, I will. You would drive the most sane person in the planet nuts.
All day.
Go to her. I know her nothing.
Well, don't you remember that this is all fake anyway?
I know her nothing. I know her
nothing.
One
of my favorite
lines. Yeah, you are nothing, but I love you. Yeah, you are nothing. You are. But I love you.
Pause it
right there. That was it. Back it up. Play again. I just love that.
What, the retard thing?
I'm nothing. Yeah, you are, but I love you.
Oh, okay. That was further. Sorry.
No. It was right there. It just happened.
Yeah, you are nothing, but I love you. Yes, you are nothing. You are, but I love you.
That is fantastic.
That's like to be or not to be. Like, those are
We just got a Rev Shakespeare moment.
Those words should go down in the annals of history.
You're nothing, but I love you.
But I love you.
You are nothing.
Ladies, real quick in the chat, I know we're not very popular with the ladies. Ladies, if I tell you, you're nothing, but I love you, tell me that does not give you heart flutters.
Well, I for one do way better with women that have low self-esteem.
Taser, I 100% want you to try that, and I want you to videotape it and send it to me.
Oh, well,
exactly.
Well, to be fair.
To be fair.
We somebody was just request. Druid was requesting a to be fair.
Yeah,
that's fine. Can we be done with these people?
Yes, let's be done with these people and have some fucking fun.
All right, let's have some fun, shall we?
Let's watch some puppies.
Yes, all right. You got puppies.
All right, Jello, let's see what you got for us.
I had some puppies around here, a little short somewhere. Oh, here we go.
Oh, hang on.
I'm going to slap your hand, widow. I swear to God. That puppy knew the assignment.
Hey, I didn't try.
Thank your door.
We're gonna try it again. Okay, Peanut. Come here. No.
Peanut took a dive.
Right.
He really doesn't want
like,
to be there anymore.
Fuck this shit, I'm out.
That was cool. Hey, I feel like we need to learn. Fatal
incidents of cannibalism. Oh, hey, you're in fire!
Who wants to learn how to cook? I mean, something yummy, delectable. Gordon Ramsay loves it. Let's learn how to make beef Wellington.
Beef Wellington. Follow these step-by-step instructions, and you'll make the best beef Wellington you've ever had. You'll need flaky salt, canola oil, Dijon mustard.
Sorry, forgot I sped it up.
Button mushrooms, garlic, shallots, beef tenderloin, prosciutto, and puff pastry. Start by finely chopping four garlic cloves.
Yes. I don't know.
Then six shallots. And finally, 600 grams of button mushrooms.
That's a lot of grams, man.
You've been there. Well, they really cook down small. A lot of it's
you want
water,
the mushrooms to be as finely chopped as possible. Place a pan over medium heat. Add the chopped garlic, shallots, and 2 tablespoons of canola oil. Sweat the vegetables until they start to turn translucent. Then add the mushrooms. Cook for approximately 10 minutes until the majority of their liquid has released and simmered off. Place the mixture into a bowl and put to one side. Next, we're going to season the tenderloin with salt. Pepper.
I'm getting
in
super
short,
hungry.
Both sides
I feel like
are thoroughly
I'm
be
super
next, add a
here.
Generous amount of canola
I'm
oil
sure this
to a pan.
Video
bring to
about.
High heat. Then sear the tenderloin on all sides for a couple of minutes. Ensure you sear both ends too. Remove from heat and immediately cover completely with Dijon mustard. It's important to do this while it's still hot. This ensures that the mustard flavor is fully absorbed into the meat. Next, you're going to need your prosciutto, puff pastry, and mushroom mix. Before you start crafting the beef Wellington, you're going to need to
Jesus Christ.
Tenderize the meat.
Oh my God.
That's a perfectly good spot.
The tenderized tenderloin. Now it's time to craft the beef Wellington. Place down your puff pastry. Layer on the prosciutto. evenly spread the mushroom mix. Gently place down your beef at the base. Now you're going to need some egg wash. Gently spread the egg wash over both ends of the puff pastry. Grab the puff pastry and slowly roll it around your entire tenderloin. Garnish with flaky salt. Gently pick up the beef Wellington. Heat your oven to 180 degrees Celsius, fan forced. Carefully place it into the oven. Bake for 30 minutes. Remove from oven. Serve and enjoy. Look how good this beef Wellington looks. The meat inside is juicy and tender, and the outside pastry is incredibly crispy. Just listen to how crispy that pastry is. Enjoy.
I love my mommy.
For me, nature is one of the neatest things on this.
All right.
Jello, let's hear some more music. Let's have a dance party. I think after dealing with Rev and Shanny, we need a dance party after that. I want my mommy. I hate it here. Oh, now this. That's the hat thing Jello was talking about.
Hey, that's Leapfrog Studios. With it. You ever watch Leapfrog Studios?
No.
No.
I did my time an hour now. So effusive and vain. It doesn't cut. The soul is not so vibrant. The reckoning, the sickening. Back into subversion. Pseudo psycho psycho version. Go drill your deserts. Go dig your graves. Then fill your mouth with all the money you would save. Drinking in, getting smarter again. One done, it has begun. From the day only one.
See, Jello, this was the one that you were talking about with the hat.
But no one else can see the preservation of the modern.
I actually think it's another one that I was thinking of. I wonder if they do a Megadeth song or something. But yeah, do you know this guy?
No.
Have you ever seen Leapfrog Studios?
Who?
You would like that YouTube channel. He does metal covers.
Well, send me a link to the channel for sure then, because I'll definitely check it out.
Just YouTube search Leapfrog Studios. I'm sure that's what it's called. I'm sure someone in our audience watches him. He's got like millions of viewers. There you go, right there. Leo is awesome. That's his name, Leo something or other.
Yeah, somebody was already saying Leo is awesome.
Yeah, he's good. He's his channel's great. Does great covers, a lot of fun.
Trevor from Kyo.
Psychosocial. Oh, there are cracks in the road we lay. From where the devil fell, the secrets have gone bad. This is nothing new, but will we kill it all? Fate was all we had. Who needs another mess? We could start over. Just look me in the eyes and say I'm wrong. Now there's only emptiness, but a message to bring. I think we're done, I'm not the only one. And the rain will kill us all. Throw ourselves against the wall. But no one else can see the preservation of the modern man.
It's just so good.
Thank you.
There you go. I love this one, but the Slayer one is still my favorite.
Holy shit, did I recognize Leo with the mask on?
Hey, you recognize Leo with a mask on to get a with the mask on. Okay, that was a cool effect.
Holy shit.
What the fuck was that?
Well, like it wasn't good. I'll fucking tell you that much.
Okay.
How many strains you got? Eight?
Yeah, I got eight. Gotta have, you know,
what's it gonna take? 14 for you to fucking figure it out?
It's 6.
Don't fucking start this show, all right?
Okay. Wow, I didn't. What? Go ahead. Go ahead.
That was. I do like hearing banjo covers of music, and that was pretty awesome.
All right, what's next for us?
All right. Hey Jello, what's that stupid video game that Frank and Billy keep yelling at you to play?
Power World.
You don't like it very much, do you?
I mean, it's Pokemon with guns.
Kind of.
It's for children.
I figured I would cover that a little bit tonight. Oh. So here we go.
I'm scared.
Okay. Should I even ask what the hell is going on here?
Oh, hey, Cell. Yeah, I was busy capturing a few pals while you were gone.
Kermit, why is there a Pokemon labor camp in the middle of my ring?
Okay, first off, they're not Pokemon, Cell.
Okay, fucking Digimon, whatever they are. What is going on here, Kermit?
Now, hold on. They're not Digimon either, Cell. Come on. Take a guess.
Kermit, answer my question.
Come on, Cell. Guess. I'll give you a hint. It's from that game that's totally not ripping off Pokemon.
Dragon Quest?
Can you say that? God damn it, he's from Pal World, Cell.
Right. Take these copyright infringements and politely get the fuck out of my ring.
Now, hold on, Cell. We can use these guys for labor.
We don't need slaves, Kermit. You realize that I'm supposed to be the evil one, right?
I'm still Cell, not sure what I'm watching.
They're incredibly efficient. Look, take a look at these guys.
It's totally been making working fun at it of the game that Frank and Billy are desperately trying to get Jello to play.
Non-stop for a week.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that one's not moving.
Okay, he's just taking a break.
What about that one?
He's tripping on acid.
Oh, no. Yeah, that one's a Pokemon.
Whoa.
And we're getting sued.
Oh, you mother.
Wow. I'm still not real sure what that was.
Just
like, picking, honestly.
That was just picking on Pal World, calling them a ripoff. All right, fuck it. Let's see Jules tells all. I mean, might as well go with this shit big.
Honey, I'm home. Holy blood.
Oh, God.
Jesus, what a day I've had.
Whoa!
What the hell just happened?
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought I could. I thought it would be. It would wait down at the bottom. Trade. There we go. All
right.
Holy black Jesus! What a day I've had. Fuck! can.
Oh,
just look
all.
At yourself, you gluttonous pile of fuck.
Oh,
why do you insist on eating every fucking thing you see? Now I gotta go save this stupid bitch on foot.
Mario, you have to help. Bowser's
I know. Captured the goddamn princess. And all of you fuckheads are too retarded to get her back.
Whoa. Well, you don't have to be so mean.
Suck my dick. you won't be fucking mute. I hope you have a heart attack so big it kills your whole fucking family. Oh, you're just gonna start shitting now. Why bother to get up, right? Fuck it. I'll just shit here right in Mario's yard.
Are you sure it's not Shanny?
You'll appreciate that. You know what? This actually might fucking work out. When I bring that stinking cunt back home, I now have a perfect place to put her.
Hey, Mario.
That's Shanny sitting on the couch.
No, you come dumpster.
That's it.
Yeah. Oh.
What the fuck's going on?
There we go.
Widow, stop.
Oh, Perry.
All right. So, special announcement. Guess who's coming back Monday?
Shanny.
Folks, have you missed me? I've missed you. At least my respected fans I miss. You know who you are. You've been waiting for my return to PCL? Well, here it is. Perry Caravello Live returns Monday, February 12th at 4 p.m. Pacific. That's 5 Mountain, 6 Central, and 7 East Coast time, also known as Atlantic time, on YouTube and Twitch. Be there.
I didn't realize he had been off that long.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I've been waiting.
He's been off for a couple of days.
And to celebrate Perry's return, I brought Soviet Goat's latest offering.
All right.
Because you got to love Soviet Goat.
I do love Soviet Goat.
Here's one from Tammy Faye Baker.
Tammy Faye is dead, so it's not from Tammy Faye. It's a lie.
Tammy paid you to unblock Soviet Goat as soon as you got the chance. You blocked him again.
Sorry.
Unblock Soviet Goat again. 10 goes to Joey, 10 goes to Garrett, and 0 goes to Perry.
Out of your fucking mind, bitch. He said something that is not respectful. Fuck him. He's done. Just because you fucking get unblocked doesn't mean you have a fucking free pass to fuck with me again.
But doesn't it?
Fucking, you fucking
really talk
shit again? You said something stupid? You're done. What do you think you are in third fucking grade, you piece of shit?
Welcome back, piggy bitch. Can you explain why your parents thought it was wise to cut a turd out of your ass with scissors when you were a baby?
I don't remember that situation, but I know if I had a problem taking a dump, it could have happened. I don't know. I think I was a 10-year-old or younger than that, like an 8-year-old, was constipated for about a week.
The fuck?
To take a shit. I had a major stomach ache. My mom convinced me that coffee up this thing that goes up my butt. And I said, first off, I said it was going to be too hot, and I was scared to do it. But it turned out that it worked.
Whoa, we lost Charlie.
It's not really a loss.
I mean, these things happen when you're a young child, a baby, an infant. I don't know.
Well, let's get to an offer here. This is an interesting one. This is from our friend Soviet Goat, and it's $25 for Perry to hang the wreath on his dining room lights and hang the tiger picture where the wreath was. So if you could put the tiger picture...
Out of your fucking question! Out of your fucking mind! Go fuck yourself! The tiger goes back where it belongs, does not fucking move!
Wow. It's wow, a tiger.
Such a hot reaction for such a simple task.
Good lord, man.
That hook is a huge hook. My fucking picture is not going to be shipped around my fucking apartment like it's a fucking toy.
For 25 bucks?
For a no!
For no?
Okay.
Listen up, take fuck. Pick up your phone, open Twitter, and unblock me right now. Do it and apologize to me right now. Show your butthole 666. Men holding hands. Men holding hands. Men holding hands. Men holding
after
hands.
After tonight?
Men holding hands.
Don't
men
be
holding
a goat,
hands.
You have
men
no holding chance hands. Getting men holding block. Hands. Goodbye. Any chance you had of getting unblocked is gone. Done. Over with. You're done.
You're donezo, buddy.
Fucking idiot.
It's Tammy Faye. You must unblock Soviet Goat on Twitter. I paid you to do so. You have broken the hearts of PCL fans. You said he was your favorite.
Never said anything about him being my favorite. I said block him.
He should have
said I blocked
said
he was him once.
Favorite,
he was an asshole. I blocked him twice. He's an asshole. So I'm going to, and if you're going to talk smack, trying to get me to unblock the motherfucker, then I'm going to block you as well.
What is
you're
all
not
over
even
his belly button?
You're fucking lying, bitch. The only time I say you're alive is when I'm paid to say you're alive. You're deader than fucking shit. You and your fucking husband, both of you, dead.
That's not
Perry,
a threat.
It's Jenna
He's
James.
Telling
Why don't you
Aaron
tell
Gray
your fans
that
about
tonight
forced
dead.
Yourself on Jasmine St. Clair and did the unthinkable to me? Man up.
Oh, stop. Stop going down that road. Come on, man. That was years ago. Christ.
The past
I didn't
the
force
past,
myself
Marty.
On Jazz. The only girl that I forced myself on was Jasmine St. Clair.
Jesus.
Also, don't forget how fucking stoned we were at that party. Man up. Yeah, thank you. I don't even want to remember what happened. Because actually, I don't remember what happened. I was so wasted. You were so wasted. Jazz was so wasted. But we all had a lot of fun, didn't we?
Liar!
Perry fact. Perry demands that Shalia, his hack of a hairstylist, cut his hair while he's nude and masturbating to footage of 9/11. Men holding
what the
hands,
fuck?
Men holding hands. Men
Lock
holding
em.
Hands.
Lock
Korean 1 pound Korean, 1 pound Korean, 1 pound Korean, 1 pound
Lock
Korean, 1 pound Korean, 1 pound Korean, 1 pound.
The last time you're ever gonna hear from Soviet Goat. Stupid fucking moron.
It's been the last time you're gonna hear from him for a lot of
boy.
Times.
Speaking of Soviet Goat, I was saving this for the end, but I might as well do it now. This is one last Tom's tips. This one is from our pal Soviet Goat, as you just said. He says, listen up, Chubbs. You claim all my Perry facts about you are lies. Well, it's time you prove it. If you can accomplish these easy tasks to prove just three of my Perry facts are lies, chat will never bring them up ever again. And I will accept my ban and I'll never comment on your stream again. If you refuse any of these tasks, it will be undeniable proof that the facts are true, and you must unblock me immediately.
Tell
number
me
one.
Fuck, sucker.
Number one. if you didn't slurp on Randy's boner and swallow his dude juice and only spanked his monkey, then you should be able to tell us in full detail what Randy's hot load looked like. You must tell us the texture, color, temperature.
Oh my God!
An amount of jizz you pumped from his penis. You must show on your hand where it landed and how long it stayed there.
Fuck you!
Whoa. Refusal
to do so is admitting you blew him.
I am not. No, there's no allowing. No, I am not admitting that I never went down on him. Never in a zillion years would I go down on any man. One, number two.
Perry's pretty short. He refers to it as going.
Every
up on
guy's
the
cum is white. Okay, stupid.
So does Rav.
I don't even remember.
Here, Matt. Me too.
It went on me a little bit, but fuck.
Number two. If it's true you have no interest in an Alaskan pipeline, then empty your entire refrigerator, including the freezer, onto your dining room table to prove there is not a frozen turd in there.
Oh, God.
Jesus Christ.
Refusal to do so is confirmation of you owning at least one
shit dildo confirmed.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Lie.
You're a horrible person.
Number three.
Note, and I love you.
If you didn't murder Linda's cats, prove it by calling the veterinarian who put them down or call Linda herself to tell us the truth of the matter. Refusing to call either is your confession of killing and raping her cats.
Killing and raping.
Jesus Christ.
Demented, psychotic, and fucking... a Satan worshipping fucking evil 666 demented prick. Because I am done with you, you evil, sick, perverted, demented, psychotic fuck. Get off my computer, never to return again. If I see that fucking name up there again, the computer is shut off.
Wow.
Completely shut off. Fuck. Let the
he's fucking
computer come here. The computer from here. Because I'm shutting it down.
He's drooling.
Again. We're good. You got it.
He's frothing.
He's totally
you completed
frothing.
All these tasks. Congratulations. And I will be waiting forever. If you did nothing and proved my facts true, unblock me immediately, apologize, and pay Elon Musk $8 to give me my blue check mark.
Water by saying you are a liar, 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 liar. Thank you. Good night.
Hey, everyone. After this guy finished sucking every drop of semen out of Randy, he kissed him and fed him the cone like a bird feeding its young.
Oh. Jesus.
I'm not making a comment because you are so sick, so disgusting, and such a fucking liar because you know better than to go down that fucking road.
I really want to have a verbal chat with Soviet Goat. I wonder if he talks like that in person.
You proved my Perry facts are all true. I'm commenting into you.
Good night.
You are powerless. I will comment and you can't stop me. Here I am, commenting. I win. I win. I win.
You have lost. You're a liar. 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 That's all you know how to do is lie. Lie, lie. Lie, lie. Okay?
Men holding hands. Men holding hands. Men holding hands. Men holding hands. Men holding hands.
And special shout out to Elon Musk and Men Holding Hands.
Oh my God. All right, Jello, I know that I sent you some Cobes for this evening. So let's see Cobes make some new mead. Or what he thinks is mead. I'm not exactly sure what this one is. So this should be pretty interesting.
After this, I do have one from one of your favorites.
It's mead time. We got some of this dull 100% pineapple orange banana juice. Let's go.
Oh, is he going to do pizza flavored?
And fuck my YouTube trolls there, these sad sacks.
Because pineapple goes on pizza.
You're so fucking...
No, it doesn't.
I have a girl that's crazy about me, and they don't. And that my fans are willing to pay money to fly her out. They don't have that in their fucking life. They really don't. It's fucking sad. Two cups of sugar.
Okay, so we're just using the juice, apparently? Or the honey? Yeah, way to block the camera.
All Cobes. Fucking day, people going, oh, Cobra, I'm sorry to hear you have cancer. And I'm like, I don't have it, dude. I did a tribute video for Toby Keith because he died of cancer, and I like his music. And then my YouTube trolls decided to make fun of me for crying on that video. So I pointed out to my YouTube trolls, I says, how would it feel if
about
died of that shit?
She would be sad and depressed
too. And
I thought he was a cancer.
You think that they would take the hints? But no. So now I've been getting text messages all day from random numbers. Oh, Cobra, sorry to hear you have cancer. It's like, dude, I don't have cancer. People are fucking assholes.
Eight, six, seven, five, the only three, cancer oh, in my life are
my faggot YouTube trolls.
Jesus.
Whoa.
Did he say the F slur?
Yeah, he dropped the F bomb.
Wow. I haven't heard him do that for a while. I didn't expect that one.
Cobes.
He's got to keep it spicy.
I still like quite all the honey.
Yeah, the water doesn't really...
He's so damn delusional. He starts all of his videos with talking about how his trolls can't stop thinking about him.
Like clean, he doesn't... Clean thing of there.
He's one strike from a permaban.
Dole, 100% juice, pineapple, orange, banana. No sugar added. But we kind of need sugar and honey to make mead, as well as our turbo yeast.
Why don't you use honey or sugar? Like, why do you think you need so many different kinds of sweeteners? And then there's nothing but sugar in that juice that you're pouring in there.
He wants to beat us.
Hi, I'm Wilford Brimley, and I have diabetes.
Like, that's the thing. Like, when you're making wine, you, like, add sugar if you want it to be sweet. You know? But...
This motherfucker dips Tootsie Rolls in sugar.
So sweet.
This motherfucker dips Tootsie Rolls in sugar, dude. I guarantee goddamn it. I wouldn't be surprised if he did the Buddy Elf shit and used maple syrup on his spaghetti.
Oh, fuck that. Ugh.
For all complaints about the show, please call our complaint hotline at 1-800-867-5309.
Jenny will be glad to take your message. Good Lord, Cobes.
I'm just glad he's got a spoon.
Yeah, and he's not using his fucking hand.
My troll's obsession with me is really unhealthy.
And he's got glass.
Your obsession with the trolls is clearly unhealthy.
Good night, Druid lover.
Night, Druid.
Throwing some Queen Anne chocolate cherries in there.
No! Really?
Are you leaving too, Taser? I think they're just saying goodnight to Druid.
Yeah, we should start over for people that came in late.
Yeah, why not?
Totally.
Come on, Jello. We'll just pretend it's a Baldur's Gate fight.
Hit F8. Hit F8.
F8.
We're safe scumming this bitch.
Fuck right. We did it wrong. Start over.
You think maybe if we did that, we could get it right for once?
No. No.
No.
Because we're bad at this.
No, we aren't.
We're, I mean, Jello, who are you comparing it to? Real streamers or the Geek Room? Because, I mean, if you're comparing us to the Geek Room, we got low bars to set, so.
Yeah,
I mean, let's be honest. Is anybody here on stream currently playing a video game? No? Okay. So we're a step up. We're a step up.
Throw the other pack in there. Fuck it. It's a mead recipe.
Yeah, but don't put candy in it, you fuck.
What's he putting in it?
Fucking chocolate-covered cherries.
Dude, that's not real fucking chocolate. Because I can tell by the way he opened it, that's not real chocolate. That's mostly wax.
Before we strain it. Not quite full to the top. So I'm going to top
and I'm being sexually harassed in the comments. All right.
What up, tubes? Today we're making some X-Lax mead.
Because I need to shit my pants.
I heard the X-Lax are amazing. Perfect. Chocolates.
So it'll give us plenty of room to burp it.
Please, nobody send. Nobody send Cobes X-Lax chocolate.
Our,
wrapped as Hershey's.
Turbo yeast, which will ferment into alcohol. You'll get like 20% in like a week.
The prostate cancer is coming in nicely, too.
So realistically, I can have 20% alcohol by
volume. Hope you like botulism, folks.
His pancreas is shaking like a chihuahua in December right now.
Like one-third cup.
You think he has a pancreas?
It's more like a raisin anymore, I'm sure.
One cup of that.
Do you know that raisins are just grape jerky?
No shit. I was not aware of that.
Hey, I got a serious question.
Before we,
if you're bald, what hair color is on your driver's license?
Full of yeast nutrients.
Oh, that's a random question.
I know, right?
If crime fighters fight crime and firefighters fight fire, what do freedom fighters fight?
Virginity?
That's a little bit more water.
If he's always getting laid.
I don't want a whole lot of water.
Thank you.
Thank
I
you.
I love it when someone can recognize a Carlin reference.
Oh, I did. I just was trying to fuck it up on purpose. That's for leaving me dead for six turns last night. You did.
High-end knew it.
What's that?
I said high-end knew it.
Oh, God, that's terrible.
I've been watching Coast for years.
That is funny.
And it always dawns on me how much I hate watching him.
This is like the consistency of a blood sample from Shanny.
Oh.
People are like, when's your next meat recipe, Cobra? And I'm like, I'm working on it, man.
Same difference, Ian.
Working on it.
Looks like fucked up bubble tea.
I lost the cap.
Could you imagine him trying to get a blood sample from Shanny? It would take him an hour and a half to drill in. When they finally hit a vein, they'd strike gravy.
Potion class is in session.
Well, that's why I referred to this looking like her blood. With the lumps and everything.
It does look like sewage water.
She's got like whole tater tots flowing in her bloodstream. What the fuck did I say? I said tater tots.
I've never seen him drink water. I've seen him drink juices and beers and sodas. And like he does like energy drinks mixed with like beers and wine and stuff. But I've never seen him.
That's just probably when Jessica on shows a
Dasani
up
or whatever, you know.
With me and it's gonna be fun. Troll, so
he drank green beer once.
That doesn't count.
So literally, I made a video to pay tribute to Toby Keith because he's one of my favorite country singers. And the trolls made fun of me for crying about that. And I told them, I says, dude, how would you fucking feel if someone you cared about died of cancer? You'd be fucking upset, especially if assholes were ripping on you for crying about it. And you think, oh, hey, I hate Cobra, but I'm consumed by him.
Oh, yeah, that's it, Cobes.
So now we're going around saying, hey, Cobra, sorry to hear you have cancer. And I'm like, I don't have cancer, dude. The only cancer in my life are my fucking faggot YouTube trolls.
Whoa!
Did he do it again?
He did it again.
Pop the airlock. That is a beautiful looking jar of mead, man. Not sure how it's going to taste, but there you go.
Why would he say, why would it be Jamaican for mead?
Turbo yeast. Pretty much all the ingredients are used. The ingredients I put in here. All
right.
I would just like to take a moment to point out that we here at the Sanctum do not approve of the use of that word.
What? Jamaican?
The F slur, stupid.
The F slur.
Oh, okay.
The F slur, you weird block of cheese.
I mean, unless you're emo and say it in a really cute way, it wouldn't be an emo video if he didn't say it. And I'm sorry if it makes me seem like a bad guy, but I do kind of like to hear emo say it. I wouldn't say it with him. I like to hear him say it.
You know, seeing Cobes make this mead the way he's doing it kind of reminds me when I was a wee lad. We had this local fellow named Jacob Yoder, a little Amish kid. He tried to make mead a few times, but see, he had a little problem. He got kicked in the head by a mule when he was about 4 years old. And most of the time, he just spent his time making fucked up mead and trying to hump the local trees.
Oh, God. All right, Hooves, you've got one more thing, and we'll go ahead and we will wrap up for the night. Cause
I got one more thing, too, though.
Okay.
Here, all right, well, don't post this up yet. Let him play his, but I'll follow it up with this one.
All right, is mine up?
Sorry. Hang on.
God damn it. It starts off with cleavage, so it's always good. It's
well,
your
everybody's
favorite.
So creative.
Everybody's so creative. You ever thought about having something for dinner that you've never, ever had a day in your life? And you're wondering, what can I make? Here's something right here that I promise you probably have never tried. And if you try it, you probably won't try it again. So now you get yourself about 3 pounds of ground beef and push it straight on the countertop and get a package of ramen and put the noodles right down in the middle of that. Now wrap it all up. See how good that looks? How it looks like something you probably would never do, but now that you're seeing it, you might try it?
No.
Or maybe
not. No.
And why you like your food? See how it looks like a meatball, but it's not? It looks like a big
meatball,
but it's not.
Don't do that.
Peanut butter.
Stop it.
I know you're wondering, where are we going with this? I don't know, but let's wait around and see. Oh, now you want to massage it all around that big meaty ball. Massage it. See how it looks like a chocolate cake with chocolate icing? But it's not. See how it could be a cookie with icing? But it's definitely not. That's pure ground beef with ramen in the middle. You saw it with your own eyes.
What?
And you didn't have to pay to see this either. Make sure you take all the snapshots.
Not fucked up enough.
Oh, we turning it up with Skittles now. Now it's lit. Now it's lit. What are we about to do? Flip it. Flip it over and ride. I knew it. I knew it. See how it looks like your mom will come in the kitchen and say, what's going on? But she's not around because you're an adult. That's the joy of all of this. See how everyone else is getting angry except for the person that's making it? This is the joy of making it yourself. No one can tell you what to do. Now put all that salty seasoning right on top. That way you're getting sweet, sour, and savory. A big old, looks like some sort of a cookie, doesn't it? With all sorts of stuff on top. But it's not. I promise you it's not.
I bet you her
Oh, now you want to get a pot of oil, 1700 degrees, and drop it in. Stand back far and look at it bubble. It's bubbling. You see how it's not covering the top, and you're probably wondering, why not? It's not going to be done? Well, let's wait and see. I'm not quite sure, but I know it looks different to my eye. Does it look different to your eye? It doesn't mean it's wrong. It just means it's burnt and cruncher. See how burnt and cruncher that looks? See how it almost looks like a chocolate chip cookie that somebody messed up and put everything together and threw it in the pan because they didn't feel like putting it separate? See how the topping looks sort of like something you probably wouldn't do? But we're going to try it here. Oh, we're cutting it open. Let's see how it looks inside. It's raw. Maybe it's supposed to look that way for somebody that likes to eat stuff that's not cooked all the way. But I don't really like mine like that. But it's okay. It's not all about me. Now, what's going on? You going to try it? Get some candy in there. Blow it. You're not going to try it at all. Oh! You good? You good? How it tastes? Differently to the...
Morgan Freeman. All right. And we're going to end the night on some Perry. So what is he doing for us this time, Jello?
I'm pretty sure this is a lovable Soviet goat call.
I think everybody in the chat hates me now.
Now?
Now, yeah, it's now.
Soviet goat, what's up, my man?
Goat man, what the fuck do you want?
Listen, let's be nice to each other, okay?
Why the fuck are you always being nice to each other? Pig?
It's just for fun. Come on. Listen, don't call me a disgusting pig, and, you know, I won't ask you to show me your butthole, okay?
What are you doing over there?
Get some peanut butter pretzels.
Perry.
Did I say you can have my peanut butter pretzels?
Yeah, you told me to help myself.
I didn't say that.
Phone call. Go.
Son of a fucking bitch.
So the guy who's giving you a new snowboard can't have some peanut butter pretzels that have been sitting there for... You want to know who was president the last time that those were open?
Oh, Jesus. Shut the fuck. They're not that fucking old. Talk to me, whoever I'm supposed to be talking to.
Hey, Soviet.
Hey, what's up, Tony? Hey, Tony, can you do me a favor real quick?
Yes.
Can you do a boner check on Perry?
You are disgusting.
Oh, my God, he farted. Perry.
I didn't fart. You farted.
Did I? No. I hope it's not the pretzels. Nope.
All right, Perry, listen. I just have one question, okay?
What now?
Can I see it?
See what?
Your butthole.
Come on, you know.
I don't know what the fuck you're talking about, you sick fucking animal.
I just want to see the gun you held to Randy's head.
How much fucking... I don't use a gun. I don't own a gun. I have a head injury, you fuck. You'd never own a gun. Legally.
So you owned an illegal gun that you held to Randy's head. So he put...
You are the most disgusting, lying, perverted, sick, psychotic fucking animal. Get off my fucking stream! Get out of here! I'm done with this fucking show! I'm gonna turn that motherfucker off! You fucking bricks!
Perry needs another act.
Get out of here.
Alright, so I can't see the gun.
Goodbye.
Listen. Can I see your butthole?
Goodbye.
Asshole.
Wow.
Block Soviet goat. How many fucking times do I gotta say, block the motherfucker? I'm getting motherfucking tired of this shit.
I do not love Soviet goat.
Right?
Soviet goat is the shit.
All right, folks. Well, we are going to go ahead and wrap up for the evening, but this has been a blast as always. I do want to thank everyone who's been in the chat hanging out with us tonight, listening, or just being around and enjoying the show.
Danny is definitely around.
Yes. Yes, indeed. We may try to do a pop-up show either probably Sunday. I'm still waiting to hear back if Jello will be available. I know Hooves will be out of town. But we may end up trying to do a pop-up show at some point. I will keep everyone posted. But if not, we will see you guys next Friday. Same time as always, 7 p.m. Central, 8 p.m. Eastern. But until then, my friends, as always, peace be with
Venus.
You.
Venus.
Boobies.
I should answer, where do you come from?
From the East, and I am hoping that you will give my message on the square for the sake of the widow's son.
As chairman of the Order of Skulls, and on behalf of the Council and the 322 alumni throughout the world, gentlemen, you are welcome. Welcome home.
Ye rosebuds, while ye may. The Latin term for that sentiment is carpe diem.
We've had fun, haven't we? Yeah! Shut up. All right, good.